Hi, this is Amy from the Altea store. We're going to go over a brief overview of a typical off-grid solar electric system. This is just a small demo and it can scale up as your needs require. But this will give you a good overview of the different pieces involved. Now I've got a lot of different electronics and wiring involved, so what we did is we drew up a schematic and you can check it out here and click on this link and you'll be able to actually have it up on another window so you can follow along at home. Alright, so what we have are two 12 volt solar panels. They're wired in parallel, so that makes the pluses together and the minuses together, and that keeps it at 12 volts. So I've done that within this combiner box. This is a Midnight PV3 combiner box, and we're just going to take a quick look inside, remove the protective faceplate. So you can see that we have the plus and minus from solar panel 1 coming into, the plus goes into its own breaker, and the minus goes into the negative bus bar. Then the plus and minus from solar panel 2, the plus goes into a separate breaker, and the negative goes to the negative bus bar. The output of the breakers are combined with this included positive finger bus bar. So it slides into the top of the breakers, and that combines the positive. The negative bus bar combines the negatives, and that gives you your parallel wiring. And so I also have my lightning arrestor that'll protect us from any lightning strikes. And we've got the ground going to the grounding bus bar, the positive going to the positive bus bar, and the negative going to the negative bus bar. And you can see I've also got my ground coming from my racking going into the grounding bus bar. Now I've got the rails grounded through this, and then I have a grounded mid-clamp from Iron Ridge, which is taking that ground across the rail up to the edges of the frame of the solar panels. So that is giving me a nice bonded connection through all of this. I would then go off to a grounding rod, and that would give me my nice earth ground connection. So I'm coming out of here in conduit. Now, because this is a portable system, I've transitioned to invisible conduit here, but know that this is going to be conduit going all the way into the house. So now let's transition into the house. Great, so now we are inside. So we've gone in conduit all the way into the house, and so what we have here is it's going to our DC load center. Now, the DC load center is really just a fancy way of saying breaker box. So we're going to take a look inside our DC load center. We happen to be using a Midnight Big Baby box for this. So again, we've got our combined negative, positive, and ground all coming into our DC load center. We have it going into a breaker. It's coming out of the breaker, going into the PV in to the charge controller. My negative is also coming in, and it's actually just transitioning right on out. It's just going in there as a nice place to land my negative, but it's going in, and then it's coming right back out, and it's going to the negative PV in of my charge controller. So then I've got my battery out from the charge controller. I've got the plus and minus going into the DC load center. The plus is going to a breaker, and it's going to be coming out and going to my positive bus bar. Now the positive bus bar is going to be going to my battery. So I've got the negative coming out of the charge controller going to my negative bus bar. And that negative is also going to be going to my battery. So I've got that going from the charge controller to the battery. So basically what these bus bars do is these give me a nice easy way to connect everything to the battery. So I only have one connection to the battery because that's connecting into my bus bars. So anything I need to connect to the battery, I can just connect to the bus bar through a breaker. So I have going through from the positive and the negative, I'm actually going to a cigarette outlet. This is very common to use for a DC connection. So if I have anything that would plug into my cigarette outlet in my car, or in an RV, I can just plug it right in and run it right off the battery. I've got a fuse in here, so I do have my overcurrent protection. Or if I wanted to, I could have put another breaker and gone through there. So I have that DC load. Now I also am going from the positive bus bar to another breaker, and I'm going out to the DC input of my inverter. I've got a 12 volt inverter. So I've also got the negative coming from the negative bus bar, which is just acting like the battery, going to the negative of the inverter, and I've got my ground. So the inverter is turning that into 120 volt, 60 hertz, pure sine wave, because I'm in North America. If I was someplace that used 230 volts, 50 hertz, I would just use a different inverter for that. So it's creating the AC power for me. It's going to an AC breaker box. For this, I'm just using a midnight baby box. But if you've got a lot of AC loads, you would have a bigger AC breaker box. So I'm going through my breaker, going out to an AC outlet where I have my lights. So I have got the light going through a breaker to the inverter, through a breaker to the battery. And I've got a nice meter. Morningstar happens to make both this inverter and the charge controller. And they've got a meter that I can actually connect to either one, and it will read different settings and different measurements based on what it's connected to. So that is just an overview of this demo system. We're going to do a whole bunch of other videos based on this demo. So stay tuned, and I hope you enjoyed our video. You can watch more here and check out more of us at altistore.com, where we're making renewable doable.